leader and mother of four. She is the founder of Queen's Mastermind Society, which is a networking social group for women in business. Additionally, she teaches women how to craft game-changing brands through her course known as Brand New Queen University. A former teen mom and youth advocate, Jamila will share with us today the power of networking. Please clap your hands for Jamila.
Thank you. I want to thank all of you all for being here, first of all, because like she mentioned earlier, this is your time. You can't get this back. If you came out here and didn't get anything, that means you wasted your time, okay? So because you all are here and getting all this good word and learning some things and really connecting and collaborating with people, I want to thank you for taking that step to do that. I want to also thank Evelise, because I came to her last event. I told Evelise when she was starting her agency, I said, look, if you ever need anything, I'm here. Before I finished saying here, she said, please come, please help me, okay? And I showed up. It was snowing that day, but I came anyway, and I met her. She was such a great spirit, so thank you for inviting me today. She told you a lot of great things about me. What she didn't tell you is that I'm a rebel and I'm a realist. And she didn't tell you that today this is not what I plan on having on, and she didn't know that. I was driving in the car, and I had on this royal blue dress, right? That's what goes with my red hair. And I had on this dress, and I'm like, oh, I'm going to be on fleek. I'm going to be looking good in my blue dress. And I pull out my jar of shea butter. Somebody say shea butter. Not realizing that the jar had been melted because of the sun, I opened it up to make sure my ashy ankles were lubricated, and out comes running all the shea butter all over my royal blue dress. Okay? But somebody say, teen mom.
Teen mom.
Thank God I have an 18-year-old daughter, okay? Because I stopped and I said, do you have anything to wear? And she said, well, I just have the skirt that I wore to prom. I said, give me the skirt. So I didn't plan on coming looking all royal and regal and queenly, but everything works out, right? We're all here for a reason. Okay. So today I want to talk to you all about the power of networking, okay? And this is so important because once upon a time, I came from the tribe of, I don't need anybody to do what I need to do, okay? I'm bad all by myself. How many of you have grown up with mothers, grandmas, aunties who will say, I can do it, it's just me, I got it going on? Okay, so I grew up not feeling like I needed anybody. I felt like nobody helped me when I was younger, so I'll just make it happen on my own, okay? And what I had to learn along the way was that you need people. Caesar did not build Rome by himself. You have to have a team, okay? And when it comes to networking, that is your access to your net worth. Your network equals your net worth. Now, because I look a little young, I know this may be hard for you all to believe, but I'm gonna tell you all about my small, short party life for a moment, okay? And, you know, I wanna talk to you to make sure you understand how to network, so by the time I'm done talking, you'll know how to go about expanding your network. But I know it may be hard to believe, but I don't get out much, okay? I have four kids. That means I'm home all the time with my kids, okay? I don't have no life. And not too long ago, a friend of mine came to me and she said, girl, let's go out and turn up, right? So I had to look up in the dictionary what turn up meant, okay? Just to get some clarity. And after I looked it up, I said, okay, I think I'll be down for that. Let's do it. So we went out and we decided that we were going to go, you know, to some place that we've never been before. So we went, you know, to the opposite side of town, and, you know, we said, what can we get into on this side of town? We found a spot, and we went in, and, you know, the turn up began, right? And as I was there in the event space, I started to look around and just observe everything, just look at people, who looks different, who doesn't look like they're supposed to be here. And I noticed a guy in the midst of this place, he had on a full suit. Okay, you brought a suit to the turn up. Okay, you're different. You stand out. I noticed another guy. He was dressed in all these multicolors, and then he had a backpack on. I said, okay, so you're here to work. Okay, I see you with the backpack. And then I noticed two women sitting not too far from me. And they were dressed like they were there to see the Beyonce experience. And I said, wow, you wore that to the turn up. That's amazing. And as I sat there observing, out of the shadows, a guy came and he handed one of the ladies a stack of cash, okay, about this big. And I said, wow. Because it's not often. How often do you go out and you see somebody hand somebody a stack of cash? That doesn't happen, right? Okay. So I said, wow, you know, stack of cash that big. Where can I get one, right? And, you know, I looked at her, she took the money, she smiled, and she went back to doing whatever it was that she was doing. And since I was so close, and I'm a little nosy, I just scooted a little bit up, and I said, hey girl, you know, your husband really loves you, going ahead and hooking you up with all that cash. I'm nosy, right? So she turned around and looked at me, and she smiled, and she said, that's not my husband, I don't know that man. That's what I said. This man just came out of nowhere and handed you a sack of cash, and you don't know him? What plan is that, and how can I get on that? So I said, well, I couldn't just leave it there, right? I couldn't just walk away not knowing the rest of the story. So I took a step back, and I thought of a good question to ask, and then I scooted back up, right? And I said, well, if you don't know him, is there a possibility that you may give him your phone number, right? Because he may be really interested in getting to know you. And she turned around again and she smiled. She was so nice, this nosy woman, all up in her business. She smiled and she said, well, the thing about it is that happens all the time. You see, the guy that I'm dating right now is a multimillionaire. Now, I was stuck because, like I said, that doesn't happen in my day-to-day. Does that happen to y'all's day-to-day? Okay, all right, so we still waiting on that moment, right? And I just needed to go just one step further because I had to know. I needed to know how that happens in real life, okay? And so I said, to ask you, I'm gonna leave you alone. And she said, yeah, what's up? I said, how did you meet that multimillionaire that you're dating? Please, just tell me how. And she looked up in the air for a second, and she smiled again. And she said, actually, my friend right here introduced me to him. Your network, the people who you know, they're the ones who put you on. It is not what you know. It is who you know every single time. How many of you all have friends? Anybody have a friend in here? Y'all have friends? Yes? How many of y'all have a best friend? Best friend? No best friend? Okay. How many of you all's best friends are introducing you to millionaires? Somebody need a new best friend. I am nominating myself as tribute to be somebody's friend. And what you all have to understand, the biggest thing that I learned in that experience is really understanding that, number one, you are who you attract. If you're attracting someone that you don't like, change it on the inside of yourself so you can start to attract a higher caliber of person. Some of you all have friends who've been in the same relationship for years. Different face, different person, same relationship. Some of you all attract a certain type of friend each and every time. It may be the needy friend. You keep attracting the person who always needs your help, or the person who's always using but never returning and extending their hand and saying, girl, I got you. Do you have room in your circle to have people who won't latch on and use and not give? I know I don't have that type of space. I remember going to a mentoring academy led by T.D. Jakes, and the one thing that he taught me is that it's the five people who are closest to you. You are the average of the five. You're not the top of them. You're not the bottom of them. You're right in the middle. So if you're rolling around with users, if you're rolling around with people with a poverty mentality, if you're rolling around with people who don't chase their dreams, who are just good enough with getting by from day to day, you are the average. Can you afford to be the average of the average? If I'm going to be the average, please let me be the average of the elite. Let me be the average of the first class. So I want to lay out the steps for you on how to expand your network. Because I know I had to learn the hard way. Because after that experience, I had to reevaluate my whole life. Okay? I had to start looking at my friends and saying, what are you guys doing? You're not doing enough. Who have you introduced me to? Okay? I mean, come on now. Y'all know you meet somebody who dates only multimillionaires. You just need to know what store. Is there a particular grocery store that you shopped at? Is there a mall? Is there a gas station? Okay? What is the point of meeting? Okay? Because that's how we expand ourselves, by meeting new people. We can't get to those new levels and those new heights still doing the same old things, still talking to the same old people. How many of you have had to shed people who don't reflect where you are right now? We gotta let them go. And it doesn't mean, it's not a mean-hearted thing. It doesn't mean we don't love you anymore. It doesn't mean that I don't care about you anymore. Oh, I love you. You just can't be part of my phase five. I don't have that type of space. And that's just the reality of your life situation. You gotta do better, so you can't keep yourself anchored down at the bottom just because somebody is too afraid to step up to the top. Who is gonna suffer by keeping yourself anchored? You put your kids into it by keeping yourself anchored. You limit your family by keeping yourself anchored, and most importantly, you limit yourself. So how do you expand your network? Because so often we think, you know what, I do need a new circle. I do need some new friends, right? You know, we grow up in this society, well, the society presently, they sing songs like no new friends, right? We don't rock with you, right? You can't sit with us, right? But in reality, we know that that is the best way to stay at the bottom, by feeling like you don't need anybody. So what is the way that we expand our network? So the first thing that you need to do is identify your objective, okay? It's not enough to just say, I want new friends. What does that mean? Do you want a new best friend? Do you want a business partner? Everyone's needs are different. You start by identifying your objective. What it is that you need at this particular point in your life? What it is that you need the most? If you know that it's important for you to socialize, then say, I want a social buddy. I want someone who I can go and hang out with and just be with and spend my time with. If you know it's important right now for you to learn more about business, say I really want an accountability or a business partner. Be specific about what it is that you want, because the universe can be very childish. Y'all know sometimes we just say, oh God, I just need a job. And then McDonald's call you and you say, look, I didn't mean that job. You being funny, okay? So be specific about what it is that you want. The second thing that you need to do is identify the places to bump into your new buddies. Identify your places. If you love yoga, okay, and you say, you know what, I want a new yoga buddy, I'm tired of going to yoga class and being the only person of color in the yoga class, I want a yoga buddy, all right? You know you can't sit at home on Twitter looking for a yoga buddy. Get out and get places where you can actually meet someone who enjoys doing what it is that you're looking to do. If you want a new business partner, get out there. Get visible. Don't be afraid. These are just people. We're not going to bite, right? Maybe? A little bit? Okay. All right. And then the last thing that you need to do. Now, come on in, because this is a secret. Y'all ready? The last thing that you need to do after you identify your objective and get in those places or identify those places is you need to show up and actually connect with people. Oh my God, right? That's the hardest part, because when I walked in here, I noticed people sitting here, y'all look so beautiful sitting here by yourselves, quiet and mute, looking at your phones, looking at your notebooks, not saying a word to anybody but the people that you already know. That is not going to be the key to expanding your network. You have to actually get out and then connect. Don't be afraid to just walk up and say, hey, my name is. And the most logical thing that the person who you're speaking to will do is what? Exactly. So it's not hard, but sometimes we just gotta spell it out. Because when it comes to our kids, we say, oh, it's easy to make new friends. Just walk up to them, Billy, and just say hi. But then we come out, and what do? We sit in the shadow and be like, well, I'm cute, so somebody should come and talk to me. Somebody should say something to me or whatever. You know, I'm not gonna go around talking. I don't even know what to say. That's the one I always hear. I want you all to take a moment and look to your left and look to your right. Your next new best friend could be somewhere across the room, in this room right here, right now. Your next industry connection could be right here, right now, in this room. Okay, can you afford to stay with the same network, or are you ready to expand your network? Now, I want you to repeat after me. Somebody say, your network.
Your network.
Is your net worth.
Is your network.
Very good. It's not what you know. And this is one of the things that I teach people in my branding course. So as she mentioned, I have a course. And my course is all about really teaching entrepreneurs how to step out of the comfort zone and get to their next level so they can be visible in their industry. If you're interested in a talk like this or learning more, please come and talk to me. I'm Jamila Asata, and I appreciate your time. Thank you so much.